can start.
Right. So, in the last class, we were talking about continuous surfaces and topological surfaces. So, maps which we defined were continuous. Now, we will see what is meaning of smooth surfaces. So, for that, I'll just recall some basic calculus for maybe another 5 to 5 minutes, and then we will go back to it. Then I'll give you a definition of smooth surface. So let me just give you this calculus part. So these are calculus, I think they cover in the AFS 1, but I don't know whether everyone who is attending this workshop is they attended AFS 1 or not. So let me just quickly recall it. Anyway, it doesn't matter much. So if F is a map from U, which is open subset of Rn to Rm, so how this function will look like? It will look like f of x is equal to f one of x and fm of x. So we will have m many functions, these fi's, these are maps from U to R. So these are functions, and this x that itself will be consisting of n variables. It depends upon n variables because U is contained inside Rm. And then I'm not giving you a definition of smoothness, but I'm giving you if and only if, the one which we are going to use it. So f is smooth if and only if for every I 1 to m, this fi is, if you take it, so for all these fi's, all partial derivative of all orders, they are continuous. Okay, so this result you already know. And right now, why we are talking about this? Because we have to talk about these surface patches are smooth. So for that, actually, we need this definition. So surface patches, these are maps from open subset of R2 to inside R3. So I'll give you all examples which are from R2 to R3, which are smooth. So let us see actually what are these examples. Okay. So let me take first example, F from R2 to R3. So what is this? This is x comma y. This goes to x square, x cube, and y. Okay. So is this map smooth? Is this map smooth?
Yes.
Right. And can you tell me what is derivative of this? Or let me call it as a Jacobian of this f. What is order of Jacobian? Anybody, can you tell me? What is Jacobian matrix is?
It's partial derivative of x and y.
Right. So what is this order? Srinanda, it will be 3
by 2,
right? Uh-huh. So because this is like your f1, f2, f3. And if you want a Jacobian of this f, this is given by, this will be, you will have a m cross n matrix, and here it is del f1 by del x1, del f1 by del xn. Okay, del fm by del x1 and del fn by del, is this, okay, sorry, del f1 by del x1, del fm by del x1. Right. So here actually what this will be, this will be, this is a x square. So can you tell me what is this Jacobian is? We have to differentiate this with respect to x. So here we have a variable x and y. So you will get a 2x here.
2x, 3x square, 0.
Okay. Yeah. You tell, actually I'll write it.
2x, 3x square, 0, 0, 0, 1.
Right, that is correct. So this is the Jacobian of this, and these functions are very nice polynomial functions. So certainly this is going to be a smooth function from R2 to R3. Similarly, let us see some examples which we have already discussed during your last class. So let us see that example. Suppose if I take this 0 to 2 pi cross R to R3, this map is given by theta t. This goes to cos theta, sin theta, and t. Okay. So is this map smooth?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. Why? What is the reason?
We can take the derivative cos theta first. Let us take with respect to theta.
Right. So anyway, we know that trigonometric
theta,
functions,
they are cos theta, nice functions. 0, 0, 0, 1.
Right, that is correct. Okay. So we know that whenever you have these trigonometric functions, they are also infinitely many times differentiable. So if I take like this, we come. And this vector, this we are going to call it as a sigma theta, and this vector we will call it as a sigma t. Okay. So here also this vector is f of x and this vector is f of 1. This is our notation. Okay. This notation we are going to follow. Okay. And so this is, you remember, this is actually a surface patch for cylinder, one of the surface patch for the cylinder, right? So this is for the reason I'm taking these particular examples, because we will give you our definition of smooth surface by saying that the surface patches are smooth. So that's why we are plus certain more one condition, but let me write this. So another thing which I did not give you that definition yet, but let me just write it down. So let us write down the spherical coordinates for this. So what is the spherical coordinate is? It generally gives a surface patch for sphere and
r cos theta sin phi, comma r sin theta.
Maybe one thing, we are taking r to be 1, right? So we will take
cos theta sin phi, sin theta sin phi, cos phi.
Right, that's correct, good. So see, when you vary your R na, at that time, see, generally whatever you are saying is correct, Devi. What we generally do is, when we take a spherical coordinate, we take it like this, right? So then what you get it as a solid sphere. You remember this? If you take like this, what you will get it? You will get a solid sphere. And in that case, what will happen is this R is also varies, right? R, theta, and phi, all of them varies. So you won't get a hollow solid. You will get actually a sphere, which is inside part is also there. So in that case, it is not a surface, okay? Because it is inside, interior points will be, interior points are going to be inside. So they will have actually, they won't be two-dimensional. It will be a three-dimensional object with a boundary, okay? So that's why when we talk about... whenever we talk about spherical coordinates for a sphere, always remember that our R is fixed. So either most of the cases we take a unit sphere, so it will be 1. Okay. So this is, in this case also, we have to check this also. It is very visible that this is a smooth. So let us write a Jacobian, because we need a Jacobian for this. So let us calculate a Jacobian for this. So what is a Jacobian for this? Anybody other than Devi? There anybody? Is Priyanka around or... Can anybody give me this Jacobian with respect to theta? Tell me then. Can you tell me what is this?
This is sine phi minus sine phi sine theta.
Okay. Right. Correct. Then.
Sin phi cos theta sin phi.
I'm writing theta yeah. First, so let me
zero. Write this. Okay. Okay. Then zero.
Right, that is correct. Okay. Then
cos theta cos phi.
Sin theta
cos phi.
sine theta cos phi.
Cos phi. My, what is this?
Cos phi. Cos phi. Sine theta cos phi. Next is sine phi. Minus sine phi.
Right. So this is a Jacobian for this d sigma 1, and we know that this is smooth. So all these three, these are actually a smooth functions which I gave it to you. Okay. So now once we recall this, let me give you a definition of what is a smooth surface. Okay. So to give a definition of smooth surfaces, we have to start with the regular surface patches. So let me give you a definition. So if you recall, in my motivation lecture, I was talking about why we need a regularity condition, so that those pinch points. So do you remember what are those two surfaces which were? So I gave you two surfaces. One was this cone, and another was actually the anything which is a folded paper kind of thing. So I told you that these two surfaces, these are not smooth because of, first place, this is not even a continuous surface also because of pinch point. And this is not a so smooth surface because of this line. So in order to avoid these kind of points, what we have to do is we have to give some definition which is called regularity of surface patches. So let me give you that definition now, okay? So a surface patch is called regular. So a surface patch. So what is surface patches? This is going to be a map from open subset of R2 to R3. So here I'm not taking now surface, but anyway, I'll write it down. Okay. So it's called a regular. So this is called regular. If it is smooth. See, in general, what happens is we think that smoothness is enough condition. Okay, what is your guess? Suppose if I say that if I want to ask you what is the definition of surface, then what we will say, a smooth surface, we already have a continuous surface. So smooth surface, our natural intuition just says that this max will be smooth. That is enough condition. That's what we will think, right? Do you have any other condition? Do you want to put it naturally? If you just want to think about what should be a definition, then we will just assume that it is a smooth, right? We don't think of much more conditions. But unfortunately, we have to add this extra condition, which is that. So I'll write it. So first place is sigma is smooth. That is the first condition. And we want the vectors. So here actually we are assuming this is the frame for R2, we are assuming as a U and V, okay? So the vectors sigma U and sigma V. So what are these vectors are? This is, so suppose if this is X, Y and Z. So each of them are actually, what are these? Let me just write it down up here, okay? So what is this? This is a, this frame is consisting of UV, and they are going as a X of UV. So X is a function of UV, Y is a function of UV, and Z is a function of UV. And then what is the sigma U is, this vector is, it is del X by del U, del Y by del U, and del Z by del U. So it is the first column of a Jacobian, and this is second column of a Jacobian, okay? So see, remember that, what is this actually? So see, these are functions, right? Do you understand this actually? These are functions. Okay, so this is not exactly a vector. So this will become vector if I choose a point u0, v0 from U. Then in that case, del x del u at a point u0, v0, del y del v del u at a point u not v not, and del z del u at a point u not v not, this is a vector inside. So this we denoted by x u of x u at a point u not v not, okay? So this is vector in R3. Similarly, XV, okay. So let me write this condition. So first place is sigma is a smooth, that is first condition. Second condition is the vector sigma u and sigma v are linearly independent. Independent. As I said, these are functions. So we have to say that they are linearly independent at all the points, all points. UV, or you write it as a U0, V0, that is better. U0, V0 belongs to U. Okay. So you have to check that this sigma U and sigma V, they are linearly independent at every point. So such a kind of surface, we will call it as a regular surface. Okay. So this is a definition of regular surface. So, another thing is actually when sigma U and sigma V are linearly independent. So this is if and only if you remember a cross product, then we know that if I take a cross product of these two vectors, so this should be not equal to zero. You remember this? Sigma u and sigma v are linearly independent if and only if sigma u cross sigma v is not equal to zero, right?
Yes.
Right, good. So this is what is the condition for regularity. So now let us go back to the previous example which I gave it to you, and let us check which one is a regular and which one is not a regular. Okay. So in this particular example, is this a regular function at all f? Is this a, suppose if I call this as a patch, then is this a surface patch? See, I'll tell you one thing. If you can, I don't know, right? In fact, right now also, can you open, if you open, there are online aids are there which are called 3D plots. So what you do is, during our tutorial time, let us check that if you try to draw this graph, how it will look like? It will look like this. It's precisely look like this book kind of thing. Okay. Means of course it is infinite because you understand that it is infinite. So it is like a curved, curved paper. So it is exactly like a book. If you keep your book open, then that folded paper, which I said, so you can see actually this graph will look like that. Yeah. So now can you tell me, depending upon, yesterday we have done some talking about it, right? So can you tell me where this surface will have a problem? This is a surface. Because this is what actually, if I take this map F from R2 to F of R2. So if I just look at its image, then this is going to be, by definition, this is a homeomorphism, right? Okay, you're not by definition, sorry. This map is a surjective continuous map, and you can actually check that this is injective also because of this x square and x cube. Now you will get this map injective also. So if you look at this, so this will be going to be a surface. I'll leave this for you to check it, okay? So now, where on this surface do you think there should be a trouble for smoothness? What is your guess?
Is it along z axis?
Right, that is correct, Srinanda. So if you look at along z axis, there should be a problem. So along z axis means actually what is this? That means x and y coordinate has to be zero, right? So such a things will get from x is equal to zero inside this, right? Inside this. So now what can you say about, we have to, and now I gave you a condition for regularity. What is that condition for regularity is, if I take f of x and f of y, this is y, okay. These should be linearly, these should be linearly dependent. So are they linearly dependent at that point at z axis? See here, when you have a point which is x comma 0, what will be fx? What will be f x? Oh, sorry. Sorry. I need to consider zero y actually. Yes, correct. Yeah. So at a point zero y naught, let me put it. What will be this? Can you tell me what is this?
Zero.
Are they linearly independent at this point? Hello, are you able to hear me? So this is going to be zero, right? This is a zero vector, right? So they cannot be linearly independent, right? Because one of the vector is zero. So certainly this is not a regular surface. Is this okay? This is not a regular surface patch. Is this okay?
Yes,
ma'am.
So now what can you say about this surface patch? This one, the one which was for cylinder, which we did. See, this is an example of cylinder. You remember? See, this is one of the surface patch for cylinder. So is this surface patch regular? Is this sigma theta and sigma t are linearly independent?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, because it is clear, right? Because this one is here and this zero is here. Only we have to say that sigma theta is not zero vector at all the point. But that is true because sine and cos, they cannot be zero at the same time. What about this actually, this cylindrical, this spherical coordinate? How you will show that this is linearly independent? If you want to say that this is linearly independent, how are we to show? See, for this, what you do is, by just looking at it, we cannot say it, right? Can you see it just by looking at sigma theta and sigma phi? Are they linearly independent for every sigma phi here? For every, we have to look at actually what is our range here? It is from 0 to 2 pi and 0 to pi. So can we say just by looking at this, whether they are linearly independent? So if you want to check here, what you have to do is you write down sigma theta cross sigma phi and then check what is that vector is. So can you quickly tell me what is this cross product is? So what is here? This will be sine theta sine phi.
Minus sine theta sine phi. Cos theta sin phi 0. Cos theta cos phi sin theta cos phi minus sin phi.
Right. So can you just check actually what is this product is? Cross product. So maybe I'll leave this as a... can you just quickly do it? All of you just try fast and check. Just look at this cross product and then what we will say that if you look at the norm of that cross product, we will say that that norm is not going to be zero. Okay, so maybe what I'll do is I'll leave this to you. You write down this whatever this product is, and if you took if you look at it, maybe we have a tutorial today, right? At that time we can check. If you look at sigma theta cross sigma phi's norm of this, this comes to be sine phi. Okay, and what is the range of phi is? It is from 0 to pi, right? So in 0 to pi, our sine phi is not going to be 0. So because of that, this also comes to be linearly independent in this particular patch. Okay, so this we can check during our tutorials. Okay, so so these are the examples.
So ma'am, which, may I ask a question here?
Yes.
So why are we taking the cross product, considering the cross product here, just to check whether they are independent?
Yes. Otherwise, can you see other way also? I mean, you can
since
see
phi is in the range of 0 pi, the last coordinate of the first vector is always 0. And the last coordinate of the second vector is always non-zero, right?
Right. But what about, what can you say about this? So you want to say that this is, that is also okay.
And therefore, they are linearly independent.
No. One more thing you have to check is sigma theta is not a zero. So that also you should say, but that also you can say it. Okay. If you don't want to check that is also okay. But you have to say that this is also non-zero vector. See, in our first case, what happens was the first vector was completely zero, right? So that was also case. But as you said, this might be also easier to check because what you can do here is it comes to be sine phi only, I think. So because of that,
have to check the theta and phi in this range. That's easier.
Okay. That is also fine. Or even if you can immediately check also, like for instance, if you take a norm of sigma theta, that will be a sine phi again. So because of that, it is not equal to zero. Anyways, it's okay. Okay. So whichever way you want to check. But just check that both of these vectors are non-zero vectors plus they are linearly independent for every point. Okay. So whichever way you feel comfortable. Okay, good. So now what we have here, right? So this is the definition of a regular surface. Okay, is this definition clear to all of you? What is a regular surface means? First thing we have to check that sigma is smooth. And second thing what we have to check is we have to check that sigma u and sigma v, they are linearly independent. Okay. So now let me give, so this is a definition of regular surface. Now I'll give you a definition of allowable surface. So it's a, okay, so such a surface is, okay, so let S be any surface and sigma from U to this. I'm just following our previous notation. So sigma from U to S intersection W is a surface patch. So if sigma is regular, then we call sigma an allowable surface patch for S. Okay, so what we are doing here is we are saying that sigma is allowable. I mean, this is definition. Okay, sigma is allowable surface patch for a surface S if it is regular, then we will call it allowable. And a smooth surface is, if you can have an allowable surface patch for every point, then we will call it as a smooth surface. Okay. So a smooth surface means is a surface such that for all P belongs to this surface, there is an allowable patch. sigma, search that. Here actually this definition is in the reverse. Now yesterday we were talking. So because of that, we have to say that it is allowable surface path such that P belongs to sigma U, because we are taking sigma from U to surface S. Otherwise, normally those who are comfortable, those who are familiar with manifold, in that case, our chart is those who knows manifold, those who don't, others who don't know, don't need to bother. So generally what we do is for every point P, we will have a phi is open. So U will be open subset of M to R2. And then we say that P belongs to, and we call this phi comma U chart. And in that case, we'll just say that P belongs to that chart. But here, since our definition in the opposite direction, we have to write like this. Okay. So this is a definition for smooth surface. Okay. Is this okay? So, and then you remember we were talking about charts, right? So what is the chart actually? So we... So you take all these surfaces which are allowable and which covers S, then it is called the smooth chart, okay? Plus what you need is, you need a sigma I of these UIs, I is equal to S, then in that case, this we call it as a smooth chart, okay? Oh, sorry, smooth atlas. So are these definitions clear to you? Shall we go further? I mean, we will check now.
Yes, ma'am.
So we will see now, see yesterday we have checked three examples, right? One was what, a plane was there, then a cylinder was there and sphere is there. So just now we have seen, so for cylinder, how many charts were there actually? You remember I gave you two charts, right? And those one chart was this, this example was the, our first chart, right? And then there was another chart which we took it from minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, right? Or minus pi to pi, whichever. And with the, and what was those maps were? That those maps were the same maps. Right? And so because of that, actually same conditions will be satisfied for this. So if I take this sigma 1 and sigma 2, this will give me an allowable chart, right? A smooth chart, smooth atlas. So this says that your cylinder, which the example which we checked it, this is a smooth surface. Is this okay? Right. Second thing, for sphere, this is in one of your tutorial problems. So this is actually one of the patch for the surface patch for sphere. And then we just now checked that it is linearly independent. So this is also going to be allowable surface patch for sphere. But we have seen another example. Now you, I'll leave it for you to check those. Okay, so check those surface. Let me just check whether I can see it. Okay, so you remember actually yesterday's example, chart I gave it for sphere. For sphere, we took that this chart, right? First place, you take this open set where x, y, and z, where this z was strictly greater than 0, and this point of sphere, right? You remember this? And then what was that map was? This map was from open disk to this. And what was that map actually? X comma y. This was going to x comma y comma.
Root over 1
minus x square minus y square.
Right. It is 1 minus x square minus y square. So let us just check whether this is a regular chart. So for this, to check regularity, first place is we have to check that this map is, what is this map is? This map is a smooth map. Is this map smooth? See, square root of some quantity where this quantity is always going to be strictly greater than zero, then this map is also smooth, right? See, these two patch we don't need to worry about. Only function which we have to worry about this, because what is the derivative of this? What is the derivative of this is? It is 1 upon square root of 1 minus x square minus y square minus 2x, right? And 2 will get cancelled. Okay, so it is a minus x divided, I mean this is a partial derivative with respect to x. So here this derivative do exist because this part is not going to be zero at any given point. So this is a possible. So can you tell me what is the Jacobian of this? So this function is smooth, is okay, but what about, is this a regular also? So what will be partial
zero,
derivative with respect
one.
Right, and if you look at this, this part is actually a non-zero determinant, right? So these are clearly linearly independent, right? So this also, and similarly other chart also you can check it, and they are going to be linearly independent, okay? So sphere is also a smooth surface. So all the examples which so far which we have seen it, these examples are, they are smooth surfaces. Is that okay? Except for the first one, which I gave you just now, which is like a book. And anyway, another example was, actually there is one more example is there, which is, you remember we lastly we discussed the example of cone, right? So in cone, what was the problem was actually, if I take, do you remember the example of cone? What was that actually? X square plus y square is it? Right, but suppose if I remove the negative part, so suppose if I take a x, y, z, such that z is greater equals 0 and x square plus y square is equal to z square, then in that case, this is this now surface? What I did is I removed the part which is below, right? So now my question to you is this a surface? Okay, so there are two questions is there. One is smooth surface and another is just a surface. So is this a just a surface? Priyanka, can you tell me, is this a surface? Is Priyanka there today?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
Is this a surface?
Yes, ma'am, I think.
Actually, your voice is coming low. Is it my settings is a problem?
Am I audible?
Now you are audible, yeah. Yeah, is that surface, the one which I asked you just now? This cone with what we did is we removed actually its part which is below. You're able to see the screen, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. I think it is a surface but not a smooth surface.
Right. It should be a surface, right? Because what you can do is you can just actually, in fact, you can just stretch it, right? I mean, just pull it and make it flat. So it is going to be a surface, but problem is with the smoothness, okay? So let us discuss this in tutorial, why this is not a smooth. It, of course, this should be a, this point is the one which is a problematic, and you can check very easily that at a point 0, 0, 0, it's, you don't find those regular sigma x and sigma y, they won't be linearly independent, okay? So we can discuss all these things in our tutorial. Okay, but another thing was plane. So let me leave it for you to check that plane is also a smooth surface, okay? So these things, I think plane, just look at its equation and can you just immediately see that is this, is that a smooth? What was the equation was actually your surface patch was x, y goes to? X, comma, y, comma?
T minus AX minus BY divided by C.
Right. So if you look at here, its partial derivatives, it will be what? Actually 1, 0 something here and 0, 1 something here, right? So it is clearly this part is will give you a linearly independent part, right? So this is also going to be a smooth surface. So whatever examples which we discussed yesterday's class, most of them example, except for this cone and example which I gave you first. So these are the only two examples which are not a smooth surface. Otherwise, most of the examples which we will be considering, they are going to be smooth. Okay. So let me just give one small definition for the maximum atlas. Just it is what you do is sometimes it is useful to have a maximum atlas. So let me just write it. So for a given surface, the collection of all its allowable surface patch is called the maximum atlas. Okay. So sometimes it is useful for the various reason. So let us just, it is better to have this maximum atlas. Okay. Right. So once this is done, now what we are going to do is there is one small portion is there. So those who already, it is quite important actually. And these are called transition functions. Okay, so let me just talk about it. He talks a very little about it, but I think it is it is better to have a definition of transition functions because in fact, when we talk about in general manifolds, in that case, transition functions play a crucial role. So let me just give you what are these transition functions, okay? So those who are already familiar with some kind of manifold theory, they will understand what is this, but let me give you definition for those who are not familiar with it. Okay. So now actually see here what is happening is we have a surface S, right? So let me just take what happens if two surface patches overlap with each other. That is what is this transition functions are related to. Okay. So what I'm trying to say is let me first draw a diagram. So what we have is we have this frame which is UV frame. And let us take surface S somewhere. And then suppose let us take a first. So this is, let me take as a first, what you call a surface patch. Okay. So what is this surface patch means? I'll have this map. I'll have a U1, which is a open subset of R2. And then I'll have this map sigma 1, which is a homeomorphism, and it will go somewhere. So let me just write it as a sigma 1 U1 because it's not very important for me right now. So I'm writing like this. Then suppose this is my first patch. Another patch is suppose sigma 2. Sigma 2, and it is from open subset U2 to that of, so this is sigma 2. This is sigma 1. Right. Okay. So, but in this case, what is happening is suppose if I take a sigma image of sigma 2, it is suppose if it is intersecting here. Okay. So now what is happening here is we have this intersection points, right? These are the intersection points. So on this intersection point, you have a two patches, right? Suppose if I take any point P inside this, how many surface patches you have? For this intersection, we have a two surface. I mean, right now, at least
sigma to U2.
Right, exactly. So we have at least a two patches over there. So what we are going to do is you look at this intersection. So what is this actually? This is a sigma to U2. And let us call, so this is their intersection part. Let us call this, do we need to call this thing? Okay, anyways, this will be just an intersection. Okay, sigma 1 U1 intersection with sigma 2 U2. Okay. And then actually what we will do is we will take an inverse image of this. So what is the inverse image of this thing? This thing, let us take this. So this is a sigma 1 inverse of this U, this, okay. Okay, let me denote this by something. Let me call it as a W, okay. So suppose if I take a sigma 1 of W. Okay, and W means it is intersection of these two. Okay, and then let me call this as a sigma 2 inverse of W. Okay. So now what you can see here is we have these two maps here, and this sigma 1 and sigma 2, both of these are homeomorphism, right? So I can go here and I come back here, right? I mean, I can do in any ways. So now here, what you can see is you have this map from sigma 1 inverse of W, which is inside R2, to sigma 2 inverse of W. And what map we have is we can go via sigma 1 and compose with sigma 2 inverse, right? Is this okay? What I'm doing is I'm traveling from sigma 1 and then I'm taking this sigma 1 inverse here. Sigma 2 inverse here and sigma 1 straightway. So if I do like this, I'll get a map from sigma 1 inverse of W to sigma 2 inverse of W, right? So such a kind, and these are inside R2. So these maps are called transition maps, okay? Is this definition clear to you? Transition map, I'll write it down. But see, these are from R2 to R2, okay? These maps are. And this map is clearly homeomorphism, right? And what is the inverse of this homeomorphism? What is the inverse of this map?
It is from U2 to U1.
Sigma 1 inverse.
I mean, this is right. So this, and this is also a transition map, right? Because anyway, we cannot, I mean, we don't have what you call numbering on this. So this is, so let me just write it down this, what you call, what is this transition map is called. So this is called actually transition. So this map is called transition map from sigma 2 to sigma 1. Okay, so just remember that actually whichever is so sigma 2 inverse to O sigma 1 is a transition map from sigma 2 to sigma 1. So this is a transition map from sigma 1 to sigma 2. Okay, right. So so these transition maps, now actually I talked about only about just about homeomorphism. What about smoothness? Suppose if I have a smooth thing, then what will happen? So my question to you is suppose if these two patches, sigma 1 and sigma 2, these are regular patches or allowable patches for surface S, then can you say that this map is homeomorphism? This map is a smooth map. See, this map is from R2 to R2. So is this map going to be a smooth map if these surface patches are smooth or allowable? You understand my question? You understand my question, actually, any one of you? What is your guess? You tell, and then we will think actually what to do about it. What do you think, actually? Is it going to be smooth or not?
Smooth.
Yeah, it has to be smooth, right? I mean, that is what is our guess is. But it is. But is it clear that is it a smooth or you need to prove it? See, this is actually speaking, I mean, okay, let me give you example, then we will write it. So this is actually, which is correct, your guess is that these transition maps are smooth, but this is not very clear actually that this should happen. And why I'm telling you a reason is, see, sigma 1 is a smooth, sigma 2 is a smooth, but we don't know about its inverse, right? Its inverse may not be smooth. So for example, suppose if you take a map from R to R, which takes x to x cube. Is this map, what is this map? Is this map smooth? Is this by bijection? First place, let us start with the bijection. Is this bijection? From R to R to R.
Yes, right, yes, it is.
Is it, it is, is this map homeomorphism?
Inverse is problem at zero. Hmm? Then we take the inverse map. It's bijection are continuous, but for homeomorphic we need inverse also continuous.
Yeah, but what will be its inverse? Now it is just a cube root of x. So what is the problem actually?
Okay,
see, we are not taking square root. Now we are taking a cube root. Okay. Anyways, so this map is a smooth. This map is a bijection. But problem with this map is this a diffeomorphism? Do you know what is the definition of diffeomorphism? Or forget about diffeomorphism right now. But this map is anyway a smooth map. But what about F inverse? If it were do exist, which just take a positive, not positive, you take up whatever cube root of x3. If it is negative, anyway you will get a negative and so on. And but this map is certainly not differentiable at zero, right?
Yes, ma'am. Not differentiable at zero.
At zero, it is not differentiable. So this map is, so inverse map, whenever we write, it doesn't mean that it has to be smooth. But fortunately, in case of, a transition map, that problem doesn't happen. Okay, so this is a theorem, but it need proofs. So for that proof, actually, you have to use the inverse function theorem and inverse function theorem and actually regularity condition. It is in what they do is not this, they are discussing it in chapter 5.6. So maybe we will leave it. Those who are interested, now just check it over there. Okay. So this theorem, it need a proof, and actually that proof is, we are not going to discuss it, but for time being, you just take it as a theorem, okay, without proof. But this is a true. And those who know already manifold theory, for them actually, they will recall that in general, for manifolds, smooth manifolds, we actually have to impose this condition. Means in the definition of a smooth manifold, we say that this should happen. But the way actually we are defining now these smooth surfaces in this particular fashion, where they are embedded inside R3 and regularity condition, we don't need to impose this condition. It will be automatically follows. Okay. So that is what is, this is just a remark. Okay. And we will be using this fact that transition map are smooth. So just remember that fact. Okay. So this is for actually both of those conditions. Okay. Now, another thing, remember that whenever we study anything, like even if you study in mathematics, group theory, ring theory, or topologies and so on, what we do is we try to actually collect as many as data possible, right? So here also, what we are trying to collect is, we are trying to collect a allowable surface patch. So can you keep on adding allowable surface patch to your manifold? And it is possible. By what you have to do is, you have to just take some diffeomorphism inside R2, and if you compose, then what you get is, you will get a new regular patch, and which is called reparameterization. And the reparameterization is useful when what we have to do is something, if you prove it for one surface patch, it also happens for the other surface patch. So in those kind of conditions, this reparameterization is useful. So let me just state that the proof of this thing is just follows from the chain rule. So let me just give you the statement of proposition, and we will see. I mean, we don't need to go for the proof, maybe because it is immediately follow, or you can see in that book, okay, your reference book. So suppose if you have this U and U tilde be open subsets of R2. And do you know this definition of diffeomorphism? Is that discussed earlier? Otherwise, I'll write it down. Do you know diffeomorphism word?
Homeomorphism, which is differentiable.
Not only that, for plus extra condition, what is you need?
Inverse also differentiable.
Okay. So you know that, right? So just let me. So I don't need to write it now. Unnecessarily, I moved it down. But let me just, since I moved this thing down, let me write it down. So diffeomorphism. So f is a map from u1 u2. So f is, I check the smooth map with f inverse is also smooth. Okay, so such a things are called diffeomorphism. Okay, and in that case, in fact, now one more thing happens is even if you take this is called actually invariance of domain, in this case, you can also conclude that n is equal to m. Okay, so this is called actually invariance of domain. So automatically, if you have a diffeomorphism from some open subset of Rn to open subset of Rm, and if it is a diffeomorphism, you can conclude that n is equal to m. Okay, right. So now suppose if I have a two open subset of R2, and suppose if you have a sigma is from U to R3, R3 is be a regular surface patch. Then in that, and suppose if you have this map phi from U tilde to U, be a diffeomorphism. Then sigma tilde from sigma O phi U tilde to R3 is a regular patch. So what we are saying is that suppose if you can actually compose it with some diffeomorphism and you will get a regular patch. Okay, and the sigma tilde, this is called called reparameterization. So is then called reparameterization. Okay, and I'll just of sigma. Okay. So, and I'll tell you one thing is that this proof is very nice, and you just write it down for yourself. It is just a, okay. So in this proof, what you have to do is you have to do two things. One, you have to show that sigma tilde is smooth, which is immediate because we know that composition of smooth mass is smooth. And second thing, what you have to check is you have to check regularity condition. So regularity condition will immediately follows from from two things. One is actually sigma itself is a regular, and then if whenever phi is a diffeomorphism, what can you tell about Jacobian? If phi is a diffeomorphism, what can you say about Jacobian? Is what is the Jacobian?
Invertible.
Yes, right, that is correct. So Jacobian is invertible. These two things will give you that it is also a regular patch. And this is important, as I said, whenever if I do actually certain things for one patch, I can say that, okay, this is true for all the patches. Okay. I think my time is up, right?
It's okay if you want. Yeah.
No, actually, I want to start smooth maps, but smooth map will, I think, take a time. So maybe I'll just stop it. Yes. So any doubts or shall I stop, sharing? Anyway, if you have any doubt, now we can also discuss it in our tutorial, because we have a tutorial, so we can discuss it at that time.